once again for this session. Now I will be discussing the design and detailing of a simply supported beam by using E-tabs. So this will be a quick analysis, design also the detailing which is covered, and I will be using E-tabs software for making the simply supported beam design, and I will be using CSI detailing for detailing of structures. Now let us start the design of a simply supported beam. So we will be using Indian standard codes. And the steel structure is designed by Indian code by using IS 800 2007, and concrete design will be as per IS 4x6 2000. Now currently this design is reinforced cement concrete, and primarily we require IS 4x6 2000. Make sure that the design is made as per IS 4x6 2000, and this simply supported beam let us design for a 3 meter span, and the depth will be 300 mm, width will also be 300 mm. So let us use the x direction as two grid lines, and in y direction we will be having one. Since our span is 3 meter, let us make the grid spacing of 3, and number of stories will be 1, the rest of the things are same. Now our frame is ready. We have the base here, and the story height will be 3 meter. Since we are only concentrating in the beam, so we will be designing the beam along with their support. So we are not interested in column design. So let us define the property here. Material property, let us add the concrete. And the grade of concrete will be M30 as per the design. So the rest of the things we shall take as it is. Let us add another material property for rebar. So it will be HY SD 415. So we will be using this 415 grade steel, and the properties are given here. The Young's modulus is 2 lakh Newton per mm square, and let us take the density as it is. These are the two properties which are required in order to proceed. We are going for reinforced concrete section, hence these two materials has to be defined. And yes, let us make a sectional property. Let us make this beam, and let us delete these unwanted sections. And what we do is we will be adding a new material property, and it is a concrete. Okay, so let us name it as beam. That is 300 by 300. So this is our section, and our material will be M30 grade of concrete. And here let us mention that the design type will be beam, and if you provide this option, so this structure will be designed as per the beam guideline. And let us take the cover at top and bottom as 25 mm. This is the minimum condition. As per your given site condition or as per your requirement, you can take this. Yes, we have made a section now. Let us press OK here. Let us draw a beam. So a beam is being selected, and already we have made a beam property. So let us draw from that. So we have a grid at this point, and length will be up to this 3 meter. So we have only drawn two number of grids in x axis, hence it is enough for making the structures. And let us assign the joint restraints, and let us provide a roller support at one end. At Z it is restrained, so it is restrained only at the top, hence it will be a roller. And at this point let us assume that it is a hinged end. Yes, currently we have given the condition one end is hinged and other end is roller, and it is a determinate structure. And let us go ahead from that. So we have given the support conditions here, and now let us assign the load. Let us apply 30 kilonewton live load. At the center of the beam, totally we have 3 meter span, and the load we shall take it as 3 kilonewton, and it is located at a point of 1.5 meter from the origin. So from the origin the load will be acting at 1.5 meter for intensity of 3 kilonewton. Let us apply this. Yes, we have received the load to our structure here, and now our structure is ready to analyze. Let us check the model. The model has been checked, no warning message has been generated. So our model is good to go now. And let us start the analysis. We will be doing dead load, live load, and the model factor, which is majorly used for dynamics. Introduce a file here, and this is number one, which is simply supported beam. Okay, let us save in this file, and the analysis is running now. Now the analysis is over. Let us check the parameters and since we have given a load of 3 kilonewton, our reaction is 1.5. So we can check here, and for dead load we got 3G reaction of 3.37. okay. Now let us check the shear force and bending moment. So if you apply, this is the bending moment here. Yes, our bending is 2.53 at the mid span, and the maximum shear is, we have 3.374. Since you have the dead load in UDL form and the live load in point load, so you can see the shear force in terms of triangular form. Okay. Our analysis is over. Let us start the design. Start design check. The design is being done. And let us check either the member passed. All the concrete frame passed the design check. Okay. So we have the reinforcement at the bottom, and at the top is zero. At each and every point you can see the reinforcement detail. The AST required is 261 at the bottom. Since this is a simply supported end, the bending will be a positive bending moment. Hence you require area of reinforcement only at the bottom of the section. No need of top reinforcement, and it does not take the negative bending moment. Okay. Let us save this. Our design is over, and we need an area of 261 mm² for the simply supported beam. After designing, let us detail this. Now I will be using CSI detail software to make the concrete structure detailing. Let us make a new detail, and we have already made a ETAP file, and this is our file which we have made earlier. And the ETAP is taking the coordinates, points, frame, load, everything from the saved data by using the ETAP. The data is extracted and the process is complete. Let us press OK here. Let us give certain preferences before detailing. So we can customize this as per our requirement. We need unit in terms of metric system, and let us press OK. Preference option, we can make the standard preference as per IS 456-2000. And we can see that our beam detailing will be labeled as concrete beam, that is CB, and text height. If you need the height, increased height, you can increase the height here, and the line thickness will be 0.25. If you need to increase that, you can increase before drawing the detailing. And we are only doing the beam design here, so let us include the hash. Primarily we will be using this hash in manual design, so let us use the same hash for the rebar identification. So after this hash, we will be having the rebar dia. So let us include the legs, that is if either it is 2-legged stirrups or 4-legged, and we need each and every stirrup. Section name will be given here, and we need ETAP beam label. Whatever we have given in ETAP, it will replicate here. When we are looking into the beam rebar section rules, so let us take the minimum dia as 8 mm. Starting from 8, either it can be a stirrup or a longitudinal bar, we are giving the smallest and the largest. So you have A, B, C, D, E, F, G. What is this? So you have the longitudinal bar. So it is given the letter here, and the detail of this letter and the zone is given in the picture. So let me show that. So this is the picture here. You can see that this is A. The detailing of the part A and detailing of part B is given here. And you can see the C, curtailment of the reinforcement, and the D, E part is the center, and F and G. So all the portions are given. So this is zone A and this is zone B. This is near to the column, and the next zone will be zone B, and the center part will be zone C. So this is the pattern of the longitudinal bars which we have given the reinforcement. Let us take a preference of 12 mm dia bar. We will be using stirrups as 8 mm dia, and let the longitudinal bar be heavy. Zone A, we will be having 2 bars, and zone B will be having no bars. C and D, at the portion of E, let us eliminate this portion E, and let us keep the F portion. Okay, so maximum spacing of bar will be 150 mm. And same everywhere, and minimum spacing, let us take it as 100 mm. For curtailment rules, let us use center to center span length. So this is as per IS 456-2000, so no need to look into the detail too much. Minimum number of bars in each layer will be 2, and spacing is given here. Rest of the things are okay for us. let us press OK and rebar sizes. So we don't have 6-7 dia bar in the market. It is rare now. Let us give what are the bars which are preferred by us. So let us take these bars. So these are the preferred bars. You can customize this. And the default drawing, we need concrete beam schedules and tables and concrete beam elevation and section. Grid system visibility. This is, if you need the drawing in terms of grid system, you can take this. And if you need printout in A4 size, you can give it. Text height, let us take 2 mm, and line thickness, let us take 0.2. Let us take the default preferences and let us press OK. Now we have given our customization and our detailing is in progress now. Yes. Currently we have all the detailing. What we have done is, this is a grid system. What we have made, our grid is 3 meter and we have made a beam. And this beam is named by beam 300 into 300. This is beam 1 as per the ETAP design. And this is our concrete frame plan. And you can see here the concrete beam rebar. So after detailing, you can see at the area of A you had 8 mm dia bar, and at the A and at C you have 8 mm dia bar, at F you have 2 number of 12 mm dia bar, and at G you have 1 number of 12 mm dia bar. So this is our detailing. This is for stirrups. You have 19 number of stirrups and it is 8 mm dia, which is having 150 mm center to center. So this is concrete beam rebar table. And you need bill of quantities. The total volume of concrete which is required is 0.270 of cubic meter, and you need 18 kg of steel in order to make this beam. So you have rebar ratio. If you divide rebar divided by the, you divide weight by volume, you will be getting this value. So this is weight and this is volume. So both, if you are dividing, you will be getting the rebar ratio. And the rebar quantity is 12 mm dia bar is required in 8.4 meter length, which is of 7 kg. And you have to purchase 8 mm dia bar for 26.8 meter length, which is 11 kg. So totally you need 18 kg. This is bill of quantities. And this is our elevation of our simply supported beam. Top, you are having 2 number of 8 mm dia bar at the portion A or throughout. And bottom, you will be having 2 number of 12 mm dia bar and 1 number of 12 mm dia bar at the center. So at the both the corners, you will be having 2 number of bar. At center, you will be having 1 number of 12 mm dia bar. So this is our zone, 325 mm. And this is our cross section. This is our reinforcement profile. And rebar quantities. This is our rebar cage. You can see here, top you will be having 8 mm dia bar and bottom you will be having 12 mm dia bars. So total number of stirrups here. This is the building information model. So how many stirrups is required, how to lay that, and what is the spacing, it is visually given here. Let us make some detailing changes. let us keep the minimum number of bar as 3 and maximum. Okay. Let us re-detail this. Yes, now we got the reinforcement throughout. You have 3 number of 12 mm dia bars at bottom, so 2 number of 8 mm dia bar at the top. So this will be our detailing, which is much easier to construct. If you are going for large structure, and you can customize. So currently whatever is required, you can make this. And let us take the print of the drawing. Let us make A4 sheet and landscape. Let us start printing all the details. For printing of the detailing is over. Let us check here. Our detailing is being printed here. Yes, you can see here, these are the list of drawings, cover sheet, list of drawings, standard detail, concrete beam, schedule and tables, and concrete beam elevation and section. So this is the standardized drawing. You can check with this. This is the concrete beam rebar. And our design is being generated as PDF format. You can straight away take the printout for tight usage. 2 number of 8 mm dia bar at top at the region A, 3 number of 12 mm dia bar at the bottom. Stirrups will be 2 legs stirrups at 100 mm center to center. Same is written. I hope that you enjoyed this session. Happy learning. See you again. Thank you.